Cartel, and thank you for joining me here in the Menosphere. And if you get the opportunity, please hit the like button, share, comment, and subscribe. Okay, let's get it cracking. With all that is happening in the world today, I thought today's subject and episode of this podcast should be very appropriate, which is interracial relationships. This will be part one of two, of a two-part episode, excuse me, and will love, conquer, you know, will conquer all in this racial division in this country. I don't know if it will, but I think knowledge and understanding will basically win the day. But, you know, there are certain situations with interracial couples that, you know, given the current situation, could divide them because they will have different points of view in term of, you know, who's right and who's wrong. So, you know, just giving my own point of view and from my own perspective on this, I am a black man, you know, I'm a black male, lived in the United States all of my life, grew up in Chicago. Well, anyhow, I've dated black women, Caucasian women, Latino women, Asian women, etc. But a black man dating a white woman is an experience. Now, Spike Lee actually gracefully called this Jungle Fever, which it was a movie from 1991 that Spike Lee directed. So let me share a little bit of my own story, you know, in terms of today's subject matter, interracial relationships. Okay, so I'll just pick one out of, you know, a memory that I have, and it was this. I actually met this woman years and years ago, got into a relationship with her, and she had already had children and things like that. So me wanting to be with this person and do the right thing, I end up packing up and moving to this very, very, very small town. And I can basically tell you that it was not a good situation because I was probably one of two black people that lived in this place, and this place would fall off the map. Now, I'm not going to be too revealing about this because I don't want to give this person, you know, any more glorification than even talking about her. But anyhow, I got into a relationship with this person, end up packing up, moving from Chicago, moving to this very, very small place where, like I said, there was just one of two black people that lived in this town. And this town was very, very racist. I could recall a situation that I had stopped by this liquor store to, I guess, grab a six pack of beer and things like that and some cigars. And this woman, I guess she was the owner, she might have been the owner of the store. So she comes up to me and asks me, "Hey, are you the mailman?" And I'm like, "No." And she goes on to say, "Well, that's funny because I've never seen your kind around here." And my response was, "My kind? Which kind is that?" And she said to me, "Well, you know, colored. I'm like, excuse me, colored? I mean black. And at that point, I ended up just getting, getting what I needed to get out of there, and I stormed out, and this woman was waiting in the car with her children. So after we got home, back to her place and whatnot, I pulled her to the side and I asked her, I'm like, do you really seriously want to raise kids here? I mean, this town is racist. This is a racist town. And I kept emphasizing that to her. But of course, it was all about her, so she didn't want to hear it. She didn't want to hear what this place was. And why would she? She was a Caucasian woman, and it didn't matter. And she did not, I repeat, did not understand, nor did she want to, because it was all about her and it was nothing else. Nothing else mattered. So if you are in a interracial relationship, and I'm talking to black men out there, I'm even talking to white men that may be involved with a Latino woman, or may be involved with a black woman, and these things happen. If these things happen to you, I'm telling you, and like I said, I don't care if you are a man or a woman listening to this. If the person, your significant other, is not willing to stand with you, then you kick them to the curb and stand alone. Because the situation with race is hard enough to deal with two people debating and having these debates. And then when something does happen, in terms of a racial incident, which I've been through many of them as a black man, and trying to tell your Caucasian other half that this is actually happening and they refuse to see the situation, then that relationship and the so-called love that you have with this other person, it's definitely not going to last. It is going to tank. It is going to go downhill from there. And please believe me, I know from experience that this is such a touchy subject, especially now with the killing of black men that seems to be going on, every few days. It is one of those situations where it is going to test you. It is going to test you if you are in a relationship with someone from a different cultural background. It is going to be very challenging. It is going to be conversations. It is going to be family gatherings, which now with COVID-19, which it's slowly, the cases are slowly declining. So you might have more family gatherings where this subject will come up, and it is going to be very touchy, especially if you're a black person and you're going to a function where it's predominantly Caucasian. There are going to be conversations, and someone will say something, and it is no fault of anybody's, it's just the individual person. Someone will say something ignorant. I'm just letting you know and throwing it out there. Someone will say something ignorant, and it is not going to go over well, and that is going to cause problems within this interracial relationship. And it does. And I'm no stranger to it. And this is why, if you know, and I've gone through this a few times, even as recent as a couple of years ago, but I'll explain that in the part two of this interracial segment that I'm doing. Okay, so the bottom line is it is going to be tough if you decide. If you decide that you are going to get into a interracial relationship, it is going to be very, very difficult. It is going to be very, very difficult family-wise. It is going to be very difficult, you know, with cultural differences. And my solution to that is there has to be understanding, because without understanding and empathy for the other person, then it is not going to work out. It is going to actually be a disaster, pretty much. I mean, and I'm only talking from the point of view of a black male that has dated. That has dated white women. It is not going to go over well, like in the case of if that other person doesn't understand your problem. You know, being in a place where it's predominantly Caucasian, and you know, the person feels like that they're being looked at, they're being scoped out, and things like that. It is very challenging. I'm pretty sure that it was very challenging for a couple called the Lovings, way back in the day. And they actually have a law named after them that interracial marriages and relationships were legal because it was illegal. You know, it wasn't legal. There was a time you weren't able to date who you wanted to date or marry who you wanted to marry and see who you wanted to see. It wasn't that way at all. And I think to a certain degree, there are certain, I would say there are certain things and preconceived notions that people have about, you know, other ethnic groups. I mean, I remember when I first came to Dubuque. I remember before I even opened my mouth that there were these preconceived notions about me. And there's this image that, you know, we project and whatnot onto ourselves. There's this image and the way one talks and the way they carry themselves and you know that sort of thing. People really, especially here in Dubuque, like when I came here, people, before I even opened my mouth, they assumed certain things. You know, now I am a black man from the north side of Chicago. That's where I grew up. So I had always been raised, okay, I was raised by a single mom and things like that. And my mom always taught us not to see the color of someone's skin, but always judge them by their character. And that's something that I had gone through life doing. You know, if you know someone's an a-hole, you know, whether they're black, white, or whatever, I'm gonna tell them they're a-hole. And that's not because they happen to be white or whatever. I'm gonna call them an a-hole because they're an a-hole. And that's it. I mean, so here's the bottom line with this part one of interracial relationships. I really do think that in order to move forward, not only in America, but in other places as well that are dealing with racism. I believe that the only way that an interracial relationship will survive is through understanding. Through understanding and education. Because without educating oneself on what another culture may be experiencing, then how do you know? How do you know how to kind of tackle the situation and save your relationship? Because there were times during the last relationship I had that I was ready to walk out because this other person just did not understand. They didn't understand. They didn't want to understand what was going on. And I'll go into detail on that particular story, like in the next podcast. But what I want to do, just wrap this up, is just to say to you all, if you are thinking about getting involved in an interracial relationship, just know one thing, and that is it's tough. It's difficult. It is not easy. And in order for you to survive with whether they're black, white, or whatever, in order to survive and for that relationship to survive, you're going to have to understand and come to an understanding with each other, and you have to ask the tough questions. And that question is, and this is something that maybe if I would have done it a long time ago, then things might have turned a corner and changed with some of the interactions I've had with Caucasian women. And that is this: are you willing? And these questions need to be asked. Are you willing? You know what you're getting into. Are you willing, no matter what, to weather the storm? And that question has to be asked. Okay, I'm going to wrap this up for now and just say to you, if you are ready to get into an interracial relationship, just take time out to think about all of the possibilities, not just the possible great things that could come from it, but think about the other things that's going to come along with it. The long nights, the conversations, in terms of race, someone and some family member saying something out of pocket to the black person or the Latino person or whatever person that someone may be dating. And these stereotypes, I mean, and these little cracks, and I've gone through it, and that's why I am speaking straight from experience, not some made up some made up thing in order to get a story going. No, these are real experiences that I have experienced, and I am speaking strictly from my point of view and experience. But in part two, I'm going to really go further into detail in terms of what I experienced, as I said, and if anyone out there is willing to weather the storm and go through it, then it may be something for you. Okay, I'm going to wrap this up by saying this is Will Martell, and I will be back again with another podcast number two, on this interracial relationship deal that I am speaking to you about. Anyhow, this is Will Martell saying so long. And remember, every day above ground is not a good day, it is a great day. See you soon.